Where's the video?
Who is you?
You know, the video you have to make.
It's been over a month and you haven't posted anything. I had to make a video for you.
I mean, I was going to make a video of my top 10 favorite movies, but I mean, those things are so...
Yeah, so do that. Turn around in your little seat. Yeah. And I'm just gonna
lie down right here. And make sure you do it.
Hey.
Do it.
Well, now that I got that out of the way and I'm wearing a completely different shirt on the exact same day, definitely didn't skip a few days. This is the same day. I'm not good at this. I'm literally making this up as I go along. I have a list here, but that's about all I have. I'm looking at the screen instead of the camera, so... Top 10 favorite movies. Here we go. How I did this, I emptied my brain and thought, movies. I took the top 10 that popped into my head and then ranked them from favorite to least favorite, but they're still favorites. So it's a top 10 list. So, yeah. I've got my water, my teacup. My top 10 favorite movies. Not the best top 10 movies of all time. My favorite movies. Let's go.
Just do it!
Avengers Infinity War. There are a lot of good comic book movies out there, that's all I'm saying. But Avengers Infinity War is probably my favorite, mostly because... Spoilers. It's been almost 2 years, but I still want to say it. Spoilers. Everybody dies. Literally, everyone dies. Well, not everyone, but a huge amount of people die. The ending, it took a risk. You know, a lot of movies, if you were to just kill off everyone, it's kind of hard to do nowadays, because a lot of people will just... Oh, they complain. You're ruining everything. I love these characters, stop, but Infinity War did it. And yeah, it's really good. I mean, we knew Endgame was coming anyway, but... Endgame almost took the number 10 place, but I had to... I saved it for Infinity War, because Endgame was just a great climactic ending with... that whole fight scene at the end, and the way everything tied up. I would put a tie, but I don't want to do a tie. I prefer Infinity War's ending. Like, if they had just ended the MCU there, I would have been... I wouldn't have cared, because it was awesome. So yeah, Infinity War makes it to number 10. Moving on.
You don't know the power of the dark side.
Number 9 spot for me is going to be Star Wars Empire Strikes Back. I'm one of the Star Wars fans that finds absolutely nothing wrong with the prequel movies or the sequel movies. Like, I get that they have their issues and they're not as good as the originals, but I still find charm in them. I like them a lot. But Empire Strikes Back... Oh my... That was... really good. I remember watching it for the first time and that iconic line...
No. I am your father.
That blew me away as a kid. That absolutely blew me away. I was like, what? and the special effect, the effects that they used for the giant walkers, and like you could see it in the first movie as well, but the second movie they had like actual walkers and ships all at the same place, and it was all really, really cool. You might be noticing a pattern here, but it's one of the darker endings. Yeah, no one dies, but still, Han Solo is frozen in carbonite and gone off somewhere, we don't know where. He was supposed to die in Empire, but people wanted him back, so they just brought him back. Luke lost a hand. The rebellion is in shambles. Rebellion is in shambles, and the Empire is winning.
Commander, I think you should hear this.
I don't know about this one.
Keep going.
Okay. Number 8 is Atlantis. I will admit, this movie's kind of grown on me a lot. I remember watching it as a kid, and I didn't like animated things, as animated films or shows as a kid. I steered clear of them until I was like 13 years old. 13, 14 years old or something. Like, Atlantis, even when I didn't like the animation and cartoons and whatnot, Atlantis always... I always went back to Atlantis. Atlantis was an animated film that I liked at a time that I didn't like animated films. And it's got a lot of, like, voice talent in there that, like, I didn't know of at the time, but now that I'm older, it's like, oh my god, that's Leonard Nimoy. Oh my god, it's Michael J. Fox. You know, you've got all these, like, people that I know of now, because I'm older and have seen more things, but it's also a beautiful film to watch. I remember, like, it's like a mix of sci-fi fantasy, and it's absolutely beautiful to look at sometimes. I remember thinking, oh my god, I want to live in Atlantis. Like, looking at all the bright, vibrant colors and all the, you know, everything that was in the world with all the flying machinery. And the Leviathan is easily one of my favorite movie monsters, even though it's on screen for only like 5-10 minutes tops. It's one of my favorite films of all time. Well, yeah. One of my favorite films of all time and favorite monsters of all time. I've spoken too long for this. On to number 7.
Fly, you fools!
Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. So why Two Towers and not Return of the King? Well, to be honest, I've seen Two Towers more. I've seen the director's edition of Two Towers more. I like the extended cut that's like 4 hours long. And, you know, on a day where I have nothing to do, I would just pop the first disc in, watch that, pop the second disc in, watch that, and that would take up like half of my day. Or at least the end of my day until I went to sleep. Just the Lord of the Rings trilogy is one of my favorite trilogies of all time. It is really... really amazing to look at. The CG, the animation, and the mod, like, they built models for this stuff. Like, they built like 3 or 4 different models for the freaking the towers and the buildings, and that takes time and work. Something you don't see in, you know, modern movies. Oh, my lighting's going weird. Something you don't see in modern movies today. Because you can just make CG things in. You can just, you know, we needed We need a few hundred thousand orcs. Just make CG models of them and throw them in there. Or we need a giant tower, you know, that Saruman to stand on, and just CG it. No, they made models. They made, like, replicas, scaled replica models to film, and just CG the people in. And it's like real people on a real tower, and like the tower's like that big, but still, it's something you don't see a lot today in a lot of films. A lot of green screen and blue screen and screen, computer graphics, stuff like that. And I remember Treebeard was a huge favorite. I loved Treebeard in that. I don't know what it was, but just, you know, a giant talking tree. The orcs always scared me. Like, they always left me like, ugh. Oh my god. Anyway, on number 6. Vertigo. Let me tell you about Vertigo. This movie, when I watched it, gave me vertigo. I was on edge this entire film, whole time watching this film. Even when nothing was happening, for some reason, I was just on edge. I was just expecting something to happen. I don't know why. Like, there's a scene where literally nothing is happening. Or, like, not nothing, but, like, it's just like a scene in a room. We're not learning anything. We are learning things, but like we're just in a room, and you feel on edge, or I felt on edge anyway. And it's a film directed by Alfred Hitchcock, and you can clearly tell because, well, he's in the thing. But when most people consider Hitchcock's greatest works Psycho, Birds. And some people think of Vertigo. I think of Vertigo. I think Vertigo is Hitchcock's best work. It kept me on edge. And I'm not spoiling the twist. Because not everybody has seen it. And I think you should check it out to see what I mean about being on edge. The entire movie. Vertigo. Alright, number 5. You know, I'm not too sure about this one. I don't know, it makes me feel like a bit of a child.
I don't care if you hate yourself, just do the damn video.
You know, I don't think you can say that word, because I don't think YouTube's algorithms will let you say that.
I don't care what YouTube says, make the damn video.
Number 5, it's How to Train Your Dragon 3. I'm laughing at myself, because I like these movies. How to Train Your Dragon 3. I didn't cry during but I cried at the end of How to Train Your Dragon. Oh man. I said Atlantis was a film that I was a film I watched as a kid. I never liked cartoons or animation as a kid. So when How to Train Your Dragon came out, and 10 years ago, I feel old. when the first How to Train Your Dragon came out, I didn't watch it. Because, you know, it's fake, it's fantasy. I wasn't into fiction that much. But when How to Train Your Dragon But when I watched the first film, because there was nothing else to do, and I watched it, and I'm like, what have I been missing? You know? And I watched the first... watching that first one, I was like, oh my god. I'm in love. Toothless is my favorite dragon in all of movie history. He's my favorite dragon. I wanted a Toothless. I wanted a pet dragon. That's how much I loved the film. And then I watched the second one in the theater. I was still kind of like, I'm a teenager watching this animated kids movie. And then How to Train Your Dragon 3 came along, and I was just like, you know what? Screw it. Cartoons are not... I had gotten over the fact, you know, not all cartoons are for kids. You know. But How to Train Your Dragon 3... Like, I know people are saying, you know, Grimmel's just another dragon hunter, and it's kind of like, you know, it's rushed, stuff happens. So, it's a beautiful ending. I loved the ending. What am I doing? I have a cup right here. That's why. Yeah, so yeah, How to Train Your Dragon 3, Hidden World, number 5 spot. Moving on up.
Dr. Grant, my dear Dr. Sattler, welcome to Jurassic Park.
This was the movie that got me into dinosaurs as a kid. Like, I mean, I didn't watch, again, as I said, I didn't watch many fiction movies as a kid, but I saw the T-Rex, like, my parents watched Jurassic Park, like, because my mom didn't like me watching, you know, anything above G. Oh, you can't watch PG or PG-13 until you're 13 years old. What? And I remember sneaking out of my room and watching the T-Rex scene at like 6, 7, 8, I don't know. But I watched the T-Rex scene and I was like, oh my god. Dinosaurs are cool. That's probably where my love of birds came from. Oh my. I love birds. Birds are my favorite animal. Birds are related to dinosaurs. Alright, stop. Scientific person. My brain. T-Rex scene. Awesome. Velociraptor scenes. Awesome. The dinosaurs. The CGI for the dinosaurs is phenomenal. There were people in suits. There were animatronics. The amount of effort and work that they put into making the dinosaurs seem realistic is top notch. It's a little disappointing in the new Jurassic Park installments. The first Jurassic Park is the best. I dare you to change my mind if there's anyone out there who thinks otherwise.
Boy, do I hate being right all the time.
Now we are moving on to the top three. Oh, boy.
Game over, man. It's game over.
Number 3 is Alien. I love Xenomorphs. I could make a whole video on Xenomorph biology. That's how well versed I am in Xenomorphs and the alien lore. Aliens. The Xenomorph. First appearance of the Xenomorph. That chestburster scene. I love the chestburster scene. That is how you do a jump scare. They're on a space station, which they can't move because they're floating in space. And this thing is massive, but you can't escape this thing. You can't kill it either, because it will eat a hole through your entire ship and leave you floating in space. Alien is the first horror movie that I ever saw. And Alien stays up there as my favorite horror movie and the number 3 spot on my favorite movies list.
I'm gonna make him an offer again with you.
The Godfather. I know. It's quite the change in pacing, isn't it? I like gangster movies. And I know that they're not technically gangsters, it's, you know, the mafia, the mob, or whatnot. But I just love I love this movie. The death scenes come out of nowhere. They look realistic. Like, it's a realistic, movie. I love the characters. Al Pacino is fantastic in this film. I don't know how I can describe how much I like this movie. I don't have it with me, but I want to keep watching this over and over and over again. That's how much I love it.
Be my friend. Godfather.
Moving on. But before we move to number 1, I have a few honorable mentions that I think deserved to be on this list. Dracula. My favorite of the original classic movie monsters. I'm a werewolf person, but I love me some Dracula. Predator. The movie that tricks you into thinking it's going to be an action film and then becomes a stealth horror movie against an alien that is hunting you down. Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Not my favorite Monty Python movie, but the one that I reference the most. And I love it. The Last Unicorn. Again, like Atlantis, I first saw it, I didn't really like it, but it's sort of grown on me. And I think it's a hidden gem. Silence of the Lambs. I love Anthony Hopkins' portrayal as Hannibal Lecter. It's no Mads Mikkelsen, but he is pretty good. And the actor that plays Buffalo Bill, I can't remember his name right now, he's also really good. There's a lot of great performances in there, and I love me some good serial killers. And this movie's got 2 of my favorites. Alright, moving on. Number 1. Joker. When I first heard that they were going to make a Joker origin film, and it was by DC, I was like, really? Why? Okay, I'll give this movie a chance. And then I saw, and I was blown away. I have never thought that I would empathize and possibly even sympathize with a character as crazed and deranged as the Joker. And he's not really crazed or deranged in this film at all. He's just a guy suffering from, you know, a mental illness. He's trying to do his best in a world that doesn't care. And eventually he's had enough. I can relate to him. And I wouldn't go to the extremes that he does, but I feel for him. It's hard to explain just how much this film sunk its teeth into me and just is latched on. In the years to come, I'm curious as to whether or not something will take it down. I don't think something's gonna take it down. The Joker is my number one favorite movie that I've ever seen. And I think it's gonna be staying up there for a long while. There. I did it. You happy now?
See, was that hard? It really wasn't, was it? Yeah. Keep making videos or else I'm gonna send my brother.
Well, everyone, thank you for watching this video. This has been Rookie Actor. Peace.